Hello guys, welcome to Brothersastic. In today's video I am going to create this micro world, the Kraken. Let's open the Photoshop and bring our imagination to life. This is going to be our 3D base structure from which we will create our micro world. I first imported this image. Let's place it here, adjust it a bit. Next I created a layer mask and then started to give the water a bit more shape by revealing some parts and hiding some. Next, I erased these parts on the front, which gave it a more 3D-ish look. Next, I added an exposure adjustment layer and added some highlights to the water surface. Then I added another exposure adjustment layer and created some shadows on the surface. On top of these two layers, I added one more and increased the exposure and created these highlights. Now is the time to add sides of the micro world. For that I used this image. I adjusted it using the distort option and here we go. I added color balance adjustment layer and hue and saturation adjustment layer to adjust the color and brightness of this image. After some tweaking, here is the result. I added same image on the right side, rotated it and adjusted it on different angle. Added same adjustment layer of color balance and hue and saturation. I added a solid color layer on top of each side and made them a bit darker. Next, I added exposure adjustment layer to darken left side. Also added a new layer to add shadows at the bottom of the left side. I did same on the right side but kept it a bit lighter than the left side. Here we go. Next, I added hue and saturation adjustment layer to the whole base and adjusted it a bit. Here we go. The base is now complete. Next, I added this ship, adjusted the perspective and placed it here. Added a layer mask to it and hide this part to make it look like it is sinking or being pulled down by some big creature like Kraken. Next, I added hue and saturation adjustment layer and tried to color correct the ship and added a ton of shadows and highlights to the ship using exposure adjustment layer. And here we go. I lit this lantern but removed it later. Next, I added this splash around the sinking ship. I added several images to add this splash which did not look very well, so I removed it later and added new one. Next, I started adding tentacles. I colorized this tentacle and set the blending mode to the soft light. Then added a layer mask and started removing some parts and made it fade into the deep. I highlighted these sucking tubes like things, I don't know what these are called, so if you know, let me know in the comments. Next, I added this tentacle on the top of the ship, adjusted it with puppet warp. And here we go. Added layer mask to it and hid some parts. Next, I colorized it using hue and saturation adjustment layer. Here we go. Next, I started adding shadows to these sucking tubes. I just created a new layer and started painting with the black brush with opacity 20%. I also created some highlights and here is the result. I also added shadows on this part of the tentacle to make it look like it is behind the sail. Also revealed this part over here. Here we go. Next, I added some water splash, but before that I readjusted the tentacle using puppet warp, then erased this extra part. Next, I adjusted the water splash on it. Then I added several tentacles around the ship and added same stuff to those also, like highlighted shadows and colorized them. The process is same. Here we go. Next, I deleted the water splash from the ship and added a new one to it. which I think looks better than the previous one. It took some time to adjust the splash, and here is the result. I added these barrels in the water to add some more details. I only added shadow to them as these were going to be very small and almost invisible. I added a canal wall fire, which did not look that great, I think. I also added this fire here, which looks like it just started. And yes, the fire needed some highlights, so I created it using the hue and saturation adjustment layer. I added a few more tentacles in the water to make the creature to look like it's very big, as Kraken is very big mythical creature. Next, I added this head of octopus, the Kraken, and made it look like it is deep in the water. It took some time to adjust the head, but here is the result. I added a slight highlight to the eye, and now it looks like this is a one-eyed Kraken or something else. I added one more tentacle because why not. Next, I decreased the saturation on all the tentacles because these were too bluish. I also threw this chest buckles off the ship as a sacrifice to the Kraken, but it did not accept. I tried to add some more details here and there, but I did not like them. I added the jellyfish and this giant crocodile. I don't know why I added that, but I removed it later. I added some dust and water bubbles to the scene, and here we go. The Microworld felt a little empty on the side, so I added some more tentacles to fill it up. Next, I added this highlight around the edge and set the blending mode of the layer to the overlay and opacity to 50%. Now I select all the layers and create a single group from it and named that the Kraken. I duplicated the group and created a smart object from it. Now is the final step, the camera raw filter. My recorder cannot see the camera raw filter for some reason, so here is what I did. I adjusted the temperature, highlights, shadows, texture, clarity, and everything else. Basically, I tried my best to hide all my mistakes, but I think I failed, and here is the result. Next, I created a smart object from the floor group and gave it a bit of bluish color, and here is the final image. After some time, I looked at the image and found the following mistakes. Ship is almost black instead of dark. Shadow is missing on the water surface. Tentacles are too blue and white. And a ton of other mistakes, which I tried to fix, and here is the final result. Here is the comparison between the two. Let me know in the comments which one looks better. And also try to find out other mistakes I made, and let me know in the comments. Comment your ideas if you want, and I will try to bring your imagination to life, but like Frank and Weenie. That is it for today's video. I will see you in the next video. Till then, check out my other videos. Thank you for watching.